So, one of the most popular comments we got on the last video was...
The last video I am referring to is our outdoor wood burner, is it worth it 4 years later? The video blew up. There's a link for it in the description below.
The most popular comments we got on the last video was... You're killing your forest. You have 20 acres, it's gonna be a wasteland because you're using 10 cords of wood a year. What are you thinking? You're an idiot burning so much wood. Why don't you just use natural gas? That's one of the funniest comments because we actually have lived here for 5 years now and we have way more trees than when we started. And that's going through 10 cords of wood a year for 4 years in a row. How is that possible? Especially considering we haven't planted a single tree. Our trees here grow like weeds. They grow so thick, we have to cut down the mature trees to make room for the young trees. And if you don't believe me, I'm gonna take you through the woods here and show you what I mean.
Okay, real quick segue here. I do wanna say I appreciate all of the comments. People are genuinely concerned and that's why they're leaving so many comments about why we should be replanting trees. I definitely suggest anybody that is cutting down trees contact the Department of Natural Resources. That's what we did. They came out to our homestead. They walked through our forest with us. They told us exactly what we need to be doing.
All right, here's just one example. This is right in the front of our property, but we've got 20 acres here. This is a tree that I plan to cut down soon. And why am I gonna cut this one down? Let's take a look. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's 10 other pine trees fighting for position to grow right here. These little 10 trees can't grow because this one huge tree and its root system are all blocking it out from growing. We are relatively new to homesteading. We've only been doing this for 5 years. So I would have thought, like many others, that, hey, we cut down some trees, we should replant some more trees. But I'm mistaken because nature's doing its thing on its own. And the trees are growing in all by themselves. And one other comment I got that was awesome from this video was talking about girdling your trees. I've heard of that before, but I didn't know exactly what it was. And I need to do some more research, and I really appreciate these thoughtful comments. But from what I understand, you cut some bark off around the bottom of the tree, and that kills the tree, and then it dries out standing, and then you can cut it down the following year, or maybe 2 years once it's dried out enough. I'm definitely gonna look into doing that more. All right, here's the next example I wanna show. This is to all the people leaving the comments. I think I got 30 or 40 comments of people saying, you're a horrible person for cutting down those trees. You're a newbie, rookie idiot. You're gonna have a desert wasteland because you're cutting through 10 cords of wood a year and you're not gonna have any forest left. This is my response to that. Take a look right here. You can't even see through these trees. You can't even see a couple feet through these trees. You can't walk through these trees. These trees are growing in so thick, they're gonna die if we don't cut down some other trees to make room for them. Yeah, so those commenters that are saying, shame on you, you should be planting more trees, you're gonna destroy that forest. I appreciate the comments because I know they mean well, but I think a logical person that was actually here, they may actually be saying, shame on you, you should be clearing some of these trees out. You should be a better steward of your land because nothing can grow, it's so thick. Look at this, you can't even walk through here. There's so many trees and it's so thick. And it's stifling the trees from growing. Imagine all the roots under the ground and fighting for sunlight. There just isn't any because it is so thick in this area. So I don't know, the argument could be made, do you leave it to nature to figure it out? And that's kind of what I'm doing now, and it's just grown a ton of trees in. Or do I intervene and cut some down and try to thin it out? I don't know, it seems like the correct answer is continue to cut them down, burn them for wood, and allow the new ones to grow in. Mostly it was positive. Mostly it was positive comments and a lot of really, really good feedback and ideas, experience from other people that have their own wood burner, and some tips and things like that. One person left a really thoughtful comment about he uses a relay on his water pump on the wood burner in order to shut the water off until it gets up to heat so that when the furnace is turned off, it's not pumping water through the ground and losing heat. I thought that was a really cool comment. I'm gonna look into that some more. They said, hey, why don't you cut the tree down, tow it up to your wood burner and then chop it up there. That's a really good idea. We did that the first year we're here with our tractor, Unfortunately, our tractor broke down beyond repair. Another question I wanted to address was, a lot of people asked, hey, why the heck are you cutting those logs so short in the video I did last? And the answer for that was, I have four girls. And the first year I was cutting just huge logs because I could, as heavy as I can lift, I can put into that wood burner. As big as I can fit, I can get in that wood burner if I can muscle it in there. But I was cutting the logs so big my girls couldn't move any of them, and they help with a lot of the chores. They split the wood, they stack the wood, and they load the wood burner with us. So I kept getting the excuse, Dad, it's too heavy, I can't do it. So sometimes I'll cut them into smaller sort of bite-sized pieces so that any one of the family can help load it and it's not just all on me. But I do a good mix of both of them. Like I said, we split some wood. I cut some pieces smaller so the girls can help with it. And then I have some big round logs that I'll throw in there if I just want to put something in there and let it burn for a day or two. Yeah, we've got lots and lots of trees here. We're really blessed where we live. As you can see, it's mostly pine trees and evergreens, but there are a few hardwoods dispersed throughout. There's a couple maple trees, a couple oak trees mixed in there, but mostly pine. That was the other comment I kept getting was, why the heck are you burning pine? If I had oak and maple trees everywhere, I would just burn oak and maple, but I have mostly pine here. I always like to look at the positive side of things, and one positive aspect of burning pine is processing it. So like, take a look at these pine trees over here. Look at how tall that is, and then there's just a few branches on the top. Huge trunk though. It's a lot easier to process. So I cut that tree down and then I cut it into rounds and I can process that thing super fast. Whereas with a maple tree or something like this, this is obviously a smaller one, but with a maple tree, you have a ton of branches and sticks coming off of it. And then you just have a very little short trunk. So in my opinion, a tree like that is a lot easier to process. You cut it down, there's very few branches you have to deal with. It's a nice straight log and I could just slice it up into rounds that I can throw in the wood burner. Whereas with a maple tree, it's a lot shorter. There's very little trunk and there's a lot of branches you have to deal with. It's a lot more work. The argument could be made, and it's true, that you're gonna get a lot more BTUs out of a maple tree than a pine. Maybe the difference in being easier to process is equivalent, but again, I have 95% pine here and very few maple and oak, so that's what I end up burning mostly is pine. Honestly, if you could count every tree here from when we first moved here 5 years ago to now, there's way more trees here now than there were before. I know it sounds crazy. It's nothing we did. It's just, if nobody was here, nobody was living here, they just grow up like crazy.